Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. This is episode 2 of Beat the Clock, the new challenge. We challenge you as a music producer to make a song or a beat within 10 minutes and post your results on YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, whatever channel you have to post your beat that you created within 10 minutes. Hashtag Beat the Clock, the new series. So what we're going to do is time myself, in this case, for 10 minutes. And when I tell them to kick the timer this time, I'll try not to talk. It's so hard not to talk in videos. I can't tell you how hard it is for me not to say anything during a video. So if you haven't seen episode 1, you can go back to episode 1 if you're interested in me kind of doing a very quick tutorial within 10 minutes. This one, I'm not going to talk as much. If you guys don't like me talking, in the next episode, I'll try and explain why I did things. Okay. But just remember, explaining why I do things takes up a lot of time. So I will try my hardest not to speak, but I will set the thing now to 10 minutes and hand it over. All right. You good? All right. So when the clock rolls, we're starting from scratch. So some people, when they do the challenge, they load up their instruments. If your instruments take a long time to load, that's fair. So you can load them up before you start, because it's really not fair with the loading time. Some plugins take longer than others, so just keep that in mind. I'm starting from absolute scratch. So once we start the timer, all right, go. Cool. I'm going to go to BusyWorksBeats.com, load up some X drums. Typical. I mean, they're my go-to. What can I say? This time I'm going to use the R&B kick and snare. All right. Set the slower tempo around 88. Again, I said I was not going to talk, but this I can talk during this part. Gonna do every kick. I'm gonna put the drums on the beat of the song. So we got an R&B vibe. Gonna open up Silent. Program a super saw patch. Again, one of the versatile sounds. 8 voices of a saw. Detune it. Turn your polyphony up. Give it a little bit of a cutoff filter. I'm gonna move it. Via cutoff A, tell it to go down over time. Turn the resonance up. Add some more voices of a saw. This time I'm going to use a lower octave. Okay, now I'm going to program pattern. Why are we on pattern 4? I don't know. Anyway, we're going to skip every other white note and create some major 7th chords, or minor 7th. So it's A, C, E, G. We're just skipping all the white notes. Make this a 9th by adding that B. So this low octave might be a little too much. So now it's just a matter of coming up with a cool rhythm. I wanted to go dun it, dun it. Just gonna copy and paste. Shorten the note lengths. Let me see what tempo I'm trying to be at. I need to be around 100. You can literally just copy and paste the chords. Make sure the top note is at that specific note. Okay, we have some strangler notes down there. And I'm going to go dun. Copy and paste. Just make sure the top note is the note you hear in here. It's going to be E. So I'm going to go dun, dun, dun. A lot of copying and pasting going on. It's a very quick technique. I showed it in a certain video. Go dun, dun. I don't don't like that chord switch. So let's go. So I'm going to send everything to the mixer, start mixing it to make it sound better. Give it a high pass filter. Let's get rid of some of that low end that's just not necessary. Give it reverb. Now we need a melodic element. Let's go with silent again so I can program a sound. And I want it to be very belly, so let's go sine wave, short decay time, long release. Play it higher octaves. And let's add some. Now a cool thing I'm going to do here is actually create an arpeggio. So I'm going to copy the chords, paste them into silent one. Hit control A, alt L. It's going to drag out those notes. Hit control G to make them group together. That may or may not. Actually, I'm not going to group them. So I'm going to hit control Z. Now I'm going to set the ARP to up mode and set the time accordingly to add this to the playlist. Set this 3 octaves. Now I'm not sure why it sounds so weird. So I'm going to hit control A, control up. Oh, you know what? The polyphony is low. So I have to turn the polyphony up so I can play multiple notes. Okay, I'm not sure why it's giving me this weird rhythm. Let's see, hold on. Now I want the pan to be controlled by an LFO. Now the last chord I'm not particularly liking, but I'm going to leave it. It's not too bad. I just don't really like it. Let's turn the pan up. Give us a little reverb. What I might do here is, see if I can, let me see if this sounds good. It might not. I'm just going to shorten it and repeat it. See if, no, it doesn't sound good. So the last two chords, I would generally change them, but to save time, I'm not going to change them. So let's create a bass line. Let's go to silent one again. And the bass line is literally going to follow the chord. I'm just going to copy the chord progression. Go to pattern 5, paste it into silent 1, hit control L, send it to the mixer, set up the low pass filter on the bass. Whoops. My goodness. Low pass filter. Set mono legato, turn portamento up. And let's do octaves. So I'm going to delete everything that's not in the root note of the chord. Whenever I have notes that are the same note, I'm going to select the second note. For instance, whenever you see AA or GG or DD, I'm going to select the second note and hit control up. It's going to transpose it up an octave. Some kind of melody. I'm going to go to Nexus for this one just to load up a quick piano. And I'm not going to play the piano because that might take too much time. Let's go to piano, grand piano, give it reverb, no modulation, pre-delay, no, yeah, decay time up, take the lows out. So I wanted to go. So this is make or break because we got a minute left. Thank you. So I'm just going to go straight through. Those last two chords are throwing off the melody, but I'm not going to worry about the last two chords. Turn the delay up. Hit control up, transpose. See if we can fix the chords in under a minute, 30 seconds. We're going to change every other note and we're going to hit control up. I mean, not control, shift up. Okay. I'm going to change it from a minor to a major chord. That's why you need to have music theory in a day. That copy and paste doesn't always work. So 15 seconds left. Let's just make sure everything works. All right, time's up officially. I'm not sure if you can hear that over the mic or not. So that was 10 minutes. So now I'm going to play the song twice through the way I formatted it. So you can see you can get a lot done once you have go-tos, once you have, you know, once you understand music theory and stuff like that. That's why we have these courses out so that you can do this very quickly. Alright, so that is the Beat the Clock Challenge, hashtag Beat the Clock. We'll leave the instructions in the video description below so you can do this on your social media platforms like Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. It's really fun to do with your producer friends, and you can even tag us at BusyWorks Beats if you're kind enough to share where the challenge came from so we can kind of make this a fun thing every week. So again, please like the video. If you like the series, please share with your friends if you think they can beat you in the Beat the Clock series. And remember, the clock is your ultimate competition. All right, so have fun with this challenge. It was fun making it, fun showing you a quick tutorial in between. Thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.